Hey everyone, Simon here for the Modern Awakened Perspective, your map for the path to enlightenment. Got a couple stories for you again today. First story is about another false flag attack, kind of like the Jesse Smollett and the Covington Catholic kids, designed to make Trump supporters look bad. Before I get into that, everyone, give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you like this content. It helps people find it further down the line. And if you've heard recently, YouTube has initiated a policy to prevent the kind of videos that I make from even being recommended. So, you know, hit the subscribe button, and that way you'll be notified. Hit the notification bell, shall I say. You'll be notified when I put out a new video. Okay, so let me get into it. Last night, Trump had a rally in El Paso, Texas, and tons and tons of people showed up for the rally and even waited outside in not the best of temperatures. And so this was another attack perpetrated there to make Trump supporters look bad. A guy with a Make America Great hat, Make America Great Again hat, jumped out of the crowd and attacked some reporters, knocked over news cameras and tripods, and you know, he was quickly apprehended, but not before he assaulted the reporters, and he screamed out, you know, "Fuck the media," and you know, did his best to make it seem like he was a Trump supporter mad at how the media portrays him. But caught on camera was the fact that he had this Make America Great Again hat on, but it still had the tag on it. So he had obviously just bought it, or someone just bought it for him, whoever's, you know, the puppet masters for this hoax. So they're caught again here in the act of, you know, trying to, you know, make his supporters look bad. This comes on the heels of the Covington Catholic kids, you know, against the Nathan Phillips Native American story, which was a setup, and then also the widely reported Jesse Smollett hoax attack, where he said that the people that attacked him supposedly screamed out, you know, "This is MAGA country," and both of these have been shown to be super fake stories, a setup to make Trump supporters look bad. Tons of holes in both of these stories. So I won't be surprised if a bunch of holes are poked in this guy's story. And I wouldn't be surprised if it's shown that he's a known Trump hater. So they keep trying, you know, to do these staged events to make his supporters look bad. That just shows, you know, how low they'll sink and what, you know, they're running out of options because everyone's starting to wake up and see how he is making America great again. And so out of desperation, they're perpetrating events like this. So, like I said, I think more information will come out here soon describing who this guy is and what his real agenda was. And hopefully we can even find out who paid him to do this, or you know, what's really going on. And you know, I'm sure we can dig real deep into it if we try. So that's the story from my perspective, and I'll see you here in the next one.